the Panay River springs, where the fresh water to the mountain sings. There lives a wonderful creation, the ruler of the Sulu nation. He's so handsome, he's so strong, he can run in the forest all day long. Guess who this wondrous creature is?
I am Humadapnon. I am the one. I am the most handsome. I am Humadapnon. But handsome creatures get tired too. I guess sleeping is what I'll do.
Thus Humadapnon lay himself to sleep. Into his dreams we shall take a peep. And thus Humadapnon journeyed to find his future bride. With the name Nagmalitong Yawa, she could be found at the village by the Hollywood River's mouth. Humadapnon took his golden boat and some brave men, and everything was going fine until when
our boat being taken by a mysterious force,
which came from an equally mysterious unknown source. They found themselves in a stagnant sea, the water the color of blood.
It's so deadly!
It took them 7 long months to cross this blood-red sea, after which they rejoiced for they were once again safe and free. But suddenly a strong wind blew them into a passageway where 2 islands always hit each other at intervals, near the Saruma River's bay. Thus Humadapnon was able to navigate his boat safely through the strait. Still, they had yet another detour as they arrive in an island one day.
Darling, dear, darling, dear, darling.
the Isle of Caravan. O handsome traveler and caravan, why don't you tarry here and take just a little rest? We'll treat you with the very best.
We're the women of this isle, beautiful,
but lonely all the while. Oh, please do stay
for just a day before you carry on your way.
Sorry, ladies, but we'll have to decline. We've already wasted so much time. We shall just leave, if that's okay. Maybe we'll turn again someday.
But travelers, it would be really mean
to leave without bowing to our queen.
And I bet that after they have met
their journey and everything, they will forget.
I believe that I've been quite rude. Your lovely presence to elude. I'm sorry, I didn't catch your name.
Give my eunuchs the name of our lovely dame.
The cream of the crop and the cherry on top. It's so undeniable that I'm the most desirable. And you can't deny this seductive eyes. I've got you under my spell and you can't even tell.
And for 7 long years, Humadapnon couldn't tell until Taghoy and Duwindi decided to try and break the spell. They traveled to Namalitong Yawa to ask for her advice. She decided to help with an ingenious disguise.
What's coming from a bamboo reed? Brothers and sisters of these seeds. Different, yet somewhat the same. A man and a woman with different roles ordained. But tonight, I need to reverse my part, a man's appearance and myself in part. Thus now, I humbly pray to the gods to grant my prayer and change the odds.
And thus with a poof, she became Buyong Sunmasakai, a lad tall and fair. And with Humadapnon's spirit friends, they journeyed to the witch's lair.
Give us Humadapnon back!
She demanded,
No!
And she won him back, single-handed. Single-handed in the sense their bloodless battle was commenced by a single round of bato-bato pick, thus she won the man back really quick.
And now, just to remove the jinx, Taghoy, fetch me something that really stinks.
And with a clove of garlic and smelly shoes, she broke Gin Mayunan's binding ruse. She prayed again to the deities divine to turn her back to a woman this time. And when Humadapnon saw her face, he was way over his head, up in space.
Yawa, can I have your hand?
Oh, but still I need it.
No, you misunderstand. Will you be my lawfully wedded wife?
Oh.
I'll share with you my death and life.
And Namalitong Yawa gushed.
I do.
And added,
Humadapnon, I love you too. But I still have to return to the people from which I descend to get their blessing and their consent.